when the environment changes, especially to a new situation, people react in different ways. And among these people is management, or the leadership of an organization or an entity. Now, the pressure on these people is usually higher than others. Why? Because the requirements of them delivering is more than, let's say, their teams or their subordinates on the individual levels. So when people are under so much pressure, with so much responsibility to handle in new and difficult and challenging situations, people will react differently. And some managers or leaders in this situation might be unrealistic in their expectations from their people, because you can't assume that things are normal, and you can't assume that everybody in your team or in your organization, you know, is like a robot, you know, initially or previously programmed to deal with whatever situation you're facing, and that everybody will deal with that in an equal and expected way. It doesn't work like this. Every human being is a universe on his or her own being, and you can't compare people to each other. So expecting that your team or your subordinates or the members of your organization will all act in a sort of in a similar manner is unrealistic, because that's not how people behave. Everybody reacts in a different way. Number one. Number two, expecting that they will react as per your expectation is also unrealistic, because you're talking about highly stressful situations in an environment that's not normal. And if it's totally in, you know, in new circumstances, you know, a new set of circumstances that people are living through, then how can you even know what to expect? Because people are lost. So what's the right way of handling or for handling this situation? Number one is, first start looking at yourself. Examine yourself as a human being and see how you are processing this new difficulty, this new change in environment. And look at it in an objective, neutral way. And project from that on the people around you. So if you're feeling stressed that, you know, whatever, stress of adaptation, or that you have to keep business going, or you have to deliver, fine. Your people have the same kind of pressures, each of course in their own way. So learn from yourself so that you can learn about others, because we're the same species, although we have variations, but we're the same species. Now, the second thing is, this is the time to be realist and to revisit your priorities. Because the situation is new. So you have to revisit your priorities. You can't act as if things are normal. When it comes to productivity and efficiency, you can't expect, you know, to maintain the same productivity and efficiency and output and operation like as if everything is normal. This is naive and childish. So definitely there's going to be a change. And your job as a manager or as a big boss, when you're exercising leadership or you're managing in a smart way, is to see how you can help your people adapt to this new reality, encourage them so that they can, you know, may keep their sanity, give them as much encouragement and hope and empowerment as possible, be there to support them, understand their individual needs, show empathy and compassion, and use every possible way so that you can assist your people or the members of your team so that they can adjust in their own way, and there will be different ways. Now, does that put you under more pressure? Of course it puts you under more pressure, because you have to now to adjust to, you know, it's not that you have a fixed working environment in the office, everybody comes, you know, known culture, everybody adapts to the culture and everything is predictable, everybody, you know, is expected to function according to known rules, you know, and things are, you know, like you're used to. No. Now it's completely different. So you have to allow for people, having different needs, and you have to satisfy these needs as much as humanly possible.